Guys, the next thing I want to talk about is how to issue pay business. Now, when we're talking about life insurance, there's really two different numbers that matter, right? One is submitting business, right? So when we submit business, that just simply means that we help the client fill out an application and submit it into the insurance carrier's portal. Now, while it's great to submit insurance, we want to make sure that our clients are approved. And not only that they're approved, the business is actually paid for by the client. So what that simply means, guys, is once the client actually pays their first month's premium, now that business is what's called issue paid. And issue paid business is the only number that matters in the insurance business, right? Because if you submitted $1 million in business and only 100,000 of it went to issue paid business, that means 900,000 didn't ever count. 900,000, it's like an inflated number. It's like a make-believe, like, oh, look, I did $1 million in business, which quite honestly, guys, a lot of companies in the industry, that's how they recognize performance is based on submitted business. I actually worked at a company that recognized us for submitted business, which I was baffled by when I came to Family First Life because it was very different, but that's a whole nother conversation. So the only thing that matters for anybody in this industry is business that is issue paid by, so business that is submitted by the applicant with our help, approved by the carrier, and then paid by the customer or the client. So that way that business actually sticks and that business is actually now on the books and the protection is actually now in place, okay? So I wanna share with you guys, for those that are new, for those that may have struggled with making sure that your business issue pays right away, there's a simple technique that I've learned that I've used that I've shared before, but I want to share again, that'll allow you to not only make sure you're submitting business, but every time you submit business, it actually issue pays. So that way you're actually putting the customer in the best position possible, which is making sure they're protected. So here's what I do, right? Obviously, once you ask your closing question, you're always going to ask for two things, right? So if Darlene was our customer and I was sitting here with Darlene, I'd say, all right, Darlene, now, I don't know if we can get you approved, but if we could, which one of these mortgage protection options is most comfortable for you to leave for your daughter, right? And she would pick whichever one she picks. Once she picks the option she wants, top, middle, or bottom, I'm gonna say, okay, great. Next step is I'm gonna help you fill out an application. It's gonna take about 5-10 minutes, super easy. Just go ahead and grab your driver's license and a voided check, and we'll see if we can get you covered. Now, sometimes you're going to hear, who uses a voided check nowadays, right? Like no one really uses voided checks. So you kind of catch them off guard and then you just simply say, okay, no worries. Just grab your banking information. We just need your routing and account number. They all just say, oh, okay, I got that. I got it on my phone or whatever. So they go grab it, right? They bring it back. And then what you do is you're just simply filling out the application. Once I get to the premium portion of the application, every application has a section that's specifically designated to the premium payment. These are the words that I say, and this is exactly how I say it. I say, now, all right, Darlene, now, if you are approved, right, I'm taking it away. Now, if you are approved, Darlene, what's gonna happen is we're gonna be notified and I'm gonna call you and let you know if you're approved. At that point, within 24 to 48 hours, your first premium will come out. That way your coverage is in place right away. And then after that, it'll just come out every 30 days. And then I just keep moving, right? And so I'm not asking the question, I'm letting them know how it works. I'm saying now, if you're approved, right, the way this works. So that's the key. If you're approved, the way this works. So what do people do? They go with the way things work. Now, if for some reason they can't make that premium payment in the next 24 to 48 hours, guess what? They're going to tell you right there and then. You don't need to ask. They're going to tell you. So just assume it all the way through. And if they react and they say, I can't do that, then say, okay, is it that you just won't have the funds or what's going on, right? Oh, I just don't get paid till, I don't get paid again till the first. Then you adjust it based on a you want to ask some questions to see if they can actually make the payment through another method. But if they can't, then just, you know, adjust the monthly payment, right? Or the draft date, I should say. So the key in all that is telling them the way this works and just moving forward. Now, some of you may not call your customer back after they've been approved. Some of you might tell your customer in the home that they're approved. And if that's what you do, that's perfectly fine. There's no right or wrong answer. It's whatever is good for your business. But just make sure that when you're at the premium payment section, you're just doing that the same way every time, not saying, here's what I did in the beginning and this is what I learned from my mistakes. I would say, now, Darlene, if we can get you approved, when do you want to start this? What do you think everyone's going to say? 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now, what's the latest we can start this, right? You're asking a client a question that, let's be honest, no one wants to take on a new monthly payment, right? Like, yeah, go ahead and start paying. You know, I want to pay tomorrow. I'm eager, right? Like, that's not the norm. The norm is they want to prolong this bill as long as they can. But if you don't provide the option and you just let them know that this is the way this works, they're going to go with it. And it's no big deal, right? So if you don't put a lot of stress or emphasis on it and you just, you let it flow and you say it with confidence, clients go with it. They don't know any other way. So I hope that helps you guys, because here's the thing. I see some of you guys on the team, you're submitting business, but then we look at the issue paid report and guess what we're not seeing? We're not seeing business issue paying. And that just simply means that you're changing the draft date for when this business is going to start. And I can tell you guys, if you do that over and over, that's a recipe for disaster, okay? So take it from me. I went through that experience. And so just make sure that you take your time, you say it confidently, you don't give them an option, and just roll with it. And if they have something to say, I promise you, they're going to tell you that they can't make the payment. But just assume it all the way. You hear Sean Mike say, our business is very assumptive and presumptive. Use that same exact approach when you're taking the payment, because I promise you it'll help you. And that's to earn a higher comp, to grow your agency, to get your numbers to where you want them to go. The only number that matters in our industry, in our company, is the issue paid numbers. And so I want to help you guys so that way you can help more clients, so that way you can earn more money and really, you know, more clients are protected and more coverage is put in place. So I hope that helps. We'll be right back.